I took my 11-year-old grandson fishing, wade fishing, right past Scott's house here. And it was late in the morning, and my grandson picked out a mirror lure, and I said, "It's too late in the morning for that mirror lure." He said, "I'm gonna use that, Granddaddy," and I said, "Okay, let's go." So we waited around Nibor Point, and all of a sudden, I heard my grandson grunt. I turned around, and my grandson, very short little fella, he was up to his neck almost in the water. He said, "Granddaddy, I've got the biggest fish I've ever got a hold of." And so I sat there and I backed up close to him so the fish could circle us. He brought in a 8.5-pound trout, 11-year-old kid. And I said, "I've got him." He said, "Granddaddy, you got that fish?" I said, "He's on the stringer, Jack. I've got him." My name is Jim Scoggins. I've been fishing Baffin Bay since the early 70s, almost 50 years.
It would be a fishing trip I took with my father. When he was getting a little older, and I told him that we would go one day and I wouldn't fish, I would just walk with him and tell him where to cast. We waded the South Shore of Baffin pretty shallow, and as I could spot fish, I'd tell him cast out past this patch of weeds, and he'd make a good cast. And I remember that day he caught 8 trout. They were all over 7 pounds. And I didn't think I'd ever get him to go to sleep that night. He just kept calling everybody he knew and telling them about it. And we really had a great time. My name is John Sutton, and I've been fishing Baffin Bay since 1957.
My family are trout fishermen, and we love to pursue trophy trout. And I guess my fondest memories are watching my wife catch her personal best and my son catch his as well. And her fish was 33 1/8, which is an incredible fish, particularly these days. But the fishing has to take number one as far as memories. My name is Scott Murray, and I've been fishing Baffin right around 60 years.
I've never seen so many black drum in my life. They were fat. They grow faster because plenty of food, because there was not near the population again. My name is Richard Underbrink. I have been fishing Baffin Bay for about 58 years of my life.
Well, as you've heard from Jim, John, Scott, and Richard, Baffin Bay is truly special. It is a Texas icon that's been widely known for supporting an incredible fishery and trophy-size individual fish. Consequently, it's been a major draw from throughout the state and country and has traditionally been a major contributor to the local economy. My name is Michael Wetz. I'm the HRI Chair for Coastal Ecosystem Processes at the Harte Research Institute for Gulf of Mexico Studies. I first got involved in Baffin Bay in 2012 when I visited with about 40 stakeholders to listen to concerns that they were having about the health of the bay.
But I would say in the last 30 years, it's really, really a change primarily because of water quality. And water quality is really the gold standard down here. Without that, without habitat, you have no fisheries.
All of a sudden, it began to where there wasn't really much to be caught commercially shrimping, and they started, some of them, trying to get maybe live bait instead of a harvest for, you know, a volume for consumption of food. And that started diminishing. Baffin Bay, mouth of intercoastal. And so that started going down. The duck flight was less. There was no frogs in the water on land, but each one I think is connected. It's just a draw down and a trickle effect that finally hit the bay.
Most of the big changes that I observed through the years is, one was the brown tide, and the years after the brown tide, how the bottom structure changed through the years. Places that had been pretty firm for wade fishermen became soggy, full of dead weeds. The drop-offs that we once fished were no longer there. They just were simple slope-offs. The lack of shrimp was another thing that I had noticed through the years as it gradually just dropped off. And places we had fished for years where the fish stomachs, intestines were full of shrimp, mostly now we're just finfish, smaller bait like that.
This time of year where you could put a gold spoon on a 7-foot rod and put it under your boat and see that spoon 7 feet deep in the water. It was that clear. And then all of a sudden, we started seeing brown tide to where the visibility for, I think as long as 2 years at a time, the visibility would have been less than 6 inches in the water, which was the demise of a lot of our seagrass in the bay.
They had observed lots of changes in the bay, but what it boiled down to was that there was a perception that Baffin Bay was not as healthy as it used to be. And that prompted us to start the Baffin Bay Volunteer Water Quality Monitoring Program to understand the water quality situation and possible causes of changes that were being observed. With the help of 17 volunteer citizen scientists, we were able to get data showing that Baffin Bay was being negatively affected by nutrient pollution, which is basically when too much nitrogen and phosphorus go into the bay, triggering algal blooms and other symptoms that can negatively affect habitat and fisheries. Since the early work with the Baffin Bay volunteers, we've conducted additional studies to pinpoint when and from where the nutrients are coming into the bay. Those studies show that there's a variety of sources, such as failing municipal wastewater treatment plants, household septic tanks, stormwater runoff, runoff from agricultural fields, among others. With this information in hand, we've now formed a vibrant stakeholder group that's actively seeking solutions aimed at reducing pollution from these and other sources. This is part of a larger, longer-term initiative that's been developed by the Harte Research Institute in collaboration with the Coastal Bend Bays and Estuaries Program. That initiative is called Bringing Baffin Back, and it's aimed at improving conditions both in the watershed and ultimately in the bay itself. Bringing Baffin Back is loosely modeled after what was done in Tampa Bay, Florida, which experienced many of the same problems that Baffin Bay experiences, and was eventually brought back to health through extensive pollution reduction approaches. Bringing Baffin Back also represents a sustained commitment by the Harte Research Institute to dramatically improve the health of Baffin Bay and the surrounding economy through partnerships between scientists, citizen groups, landowners, philanthropies, policymakers, local municipalities, elected officials, NGOs, and private businesses.
To put it mildly, Baffin Bay is a national treasure. It's not just a bay, it's a national treasure, and people have got to start realizing that. And my hope would be that not only fishermen, lot owners, but the surrounding businesses around the bay would start looking at the future of this national treasure instead of looking solely at maybe the bottom line for that one single year on increasing profits, because we need to preserve this national treasure that we have.
I think folks who care about Baffin Bay have a real reason to be hopeful. Using findings from the Volunteer Water Quality Monitoring Program, the members of the Baffin Bay Stakeholder Group have had some real tangible successes over the past year. For example, we've just developed a watershed protection plan that will provide assistance to landowners and businesses to reduce their impacts on the bay. We also just found out that the Natural Resources Damage Assessment Program is proposing to devote about $4.8 million to reduce pollution from agricultural fields in the watershed. And then finally, we're really excited to announce that Bringing Baffin Back has been accepted by Texan by Nature's Conservation Wrangler Program. And what this will do is open up new partnerships and new avenues for reaching audiences to share the Baffin Bay story with. I'm confident that if we can keep making progress at developing partnerships and finding funding to fix the problems, Bringing Baffin Back will set Baffin Bay up to be a resource that future generations can enjoy and make memories in, just like those that you heard here.